This is a short tutorial on how to use the distributive property. The distributive property is a property that tells us what to do when we have a term on the outside of parentheses. So on the outside of parentheses here, I've got a 5, and I've got parentheses here with some sort of operation inside. Now first notice, 4x and 7 minus 7 cannot be combined. If they could be combined, I would go ahead and do parentheses first in the order of operations, and then multiply them by 5. Because that's not the case, I am going to distribute this 5 so that I can get rid of these parentheses. So I'm going to take 5 times 4x, and I'm going to take 5 times minus 7. When you multiply a number by a term that has a variable, you're really multiplying the number by the coefficient, so 5 times 4 to get me 20, but then you can't forget to leave the variable on there. So 5 times 4 is 20, but I've got an x, so it's 20x. For my second one, I've got 5 times minus 7, which is minus 35. So that's using the distributive property. That's all I can do here unless they tell me the value for x. For my second question here, I've got a negative 1 on the outside, so a minus. It's okay to think of that as a negative 1. A negative 1 is essentially just going to change all of the signs because multiplying by 1 doesn't change your value. So negative 1 times 3d squared is negative 3d squared. Negative 1 times positive 2d is negative 2d. Now notice I said negative 2d, but I wrote down minus 2d. It's because those mean the same thing. I could have written plus negative 2d. I chose to write minus 2d. Last one, negative 1 times negative 6, and negative times a negative is a positive 6. Again, if it helps you, you should keep, flip, change, so you know it's a negative times a negative to get a positive. And for my last one, as you can see, I've still got the distributive property, but the 1 half's at the end of the question instead of the beginning. It doesn't matter. So 1 half times 8y squared. When you multiply with fractions, just multiply by the top number and divide by the bottom number. That makes fractions much less scary. So 1 times 8 is 8, divided by 2 is 4. So my answer is 4y squared. And then 1 times negative 4 is negative 4, divided by 2 is negative 2. So negative 2y or minus 2y. And then 1 times 10 is 10, divided by 2 is 5. There's my final answer. For our next set of questions, for my first one, I have a 10 on the outside, so 10 times 30. I'm going to multiply the two numbers and forget about the y for a moment, so 10 times 30 is 300. And then I'm going to put the y on it. And then 10 times minus 40 is minus 400, and I'm done. Before I continue these questions, I just want to point out that if I had something like 3 times 5 minus 2, I would not use the distributive property in this case, because 5 minus 2 is an expression that I can solve for or simplify. So I would take 5 minus 2, which is 3, and then take 3 times 3, which is 9. Now, if I would have done the distributive property, I still would have ended up at 9, but technically this is the order we should do it in. We should do parentheses first. Anyway, I digress. Back to the questions. Again, here I've got a negative 1, so negative 1 times 7t is negative 7t. Negative 1 times negative 1.6 would be positive 1.6s. And then a negative times a positive gives me a negative, and it's 9.2. And for my last one, again, we've got a fraction here. It's got a negative on it, so if you get a little bit confused with the negatives, not a bad idea to write that negative on the 1 instead. You only use the negative 1 time. So either write it on the top or write it on the bottom, but don't write it both places. Negative 1 times 6 is negative 6, divided by 3 is 2, negative 2, and then y squared. Negative 1 times negative 4 is positive 4, divided by 3. Positive 4 divided by 3 is an ugly, ugly decimal, so I get to cheat and just write it as negative 4 thirds. Please do not turn that into 1.3 repeating, or even worse, round it to 1.3. Leave it as 4 thirds, that's the most exact answer. And my last one, negative 1 times positive 9 is negative 9, divided by 3 is negative 3, and that's my final answer.